Now I'll show you how to do the weak D or DU typing. The first step to that procedure is to take your D tube and your D control tube, mix them, and place them in your 37 degree C heat block. They need to incubate for 37 degrees C for 15 minutes. After the 15-minute incubation period, take your tubes out of the heat block and fill the tubes with saline. Then place them in the centrifuge. Make sure you balance them across from each other. You also need to make sure that the liquid level in both tubes is very close so that they balance. Then we're going to spin these down for 60 seconds for a wash. So I'll demonstrate the washing procedure for you now. And they'll spin down for 60 seconds. So after they've spun down for 60 seconds, you can take the head out of the centrifuge, put your fingers under the flange here and push down on the shaft, bring it out like this. Then take the tubes over to the sink to decant the saline. And you're going to hold the tubes right here and just invert the tubes, let the saline run out, no shaking. Looks like this. And then you're going to resuspend the buttons in the tubes by tapping them right here. Not down here, but right here. And then the other tube like this. And you can give them a little shake like this. Then we're going to add more saline to the tubes after we've drained it out. And you want to be very careful that you don't touch the tip of the saline bottle to your tube, because you don't want to contaminate your saline bottle. So just like that, and then bring it back over to your centrifuge and spin them down for 60 seconds. Now repeat these steps three more times. So after the fourth wash, the final decant, you want to drain the tubes and then you're going to shake several times to get as much of the saline out as you can. And it looks like this. And get all the saline out. Then you can resuspend your buttons like this again. And now we'll take the tubes over and add two drops of AHG to each tube. The next step is to add two drops of AHG to each of your tubes. Then you'll spin down the tubes in the centrifuge for 30 seconds. Thank you. Then after adding the AHG and spinning down for 30 seconds, then you'll take your tubes out of the centrifuge, bring them over to the agglutination viewer. You want to roll the button up in the corner like this and just tap. And you can see the cell streaming off nice and smooth here. You can see we've lost some cells in the washing process, but we have enough to read. And so that's a nice negative. And then read the decontrol tube and the AHG phase. And see the cell streaming off nice and smoothly. A nice negative reaction as well. So the results of our DU testing on our D-tube shows negative. Now we need to go over to the microscope and confirm it microscopically. So now I'll show you how to confirm your negative reactions on the DU test microscopically. And I'm going to put the tube right there with the cells there. And looking through the microscope, I'm going to roll the tube like this. You shouldn't need to adjust the stage. It's already set. Just fine adjustments with the fine focus is all you should need. And then you look for any fine agglutinates that might be in there. Now, I see here that it's just very nice, smooth sea of cells. A few cells just loosely connected together is still considered negative. Agglutinates will show several cells kind of scrunched together. And I don't see any of those here, so this looks like a nice negative result. Now that we have confirmed the negative on the DU tube, we can record that on our result sheet. And then we need to confirm microscopically the D control. And repeat the same process. We're going to roll the tube while we look through the microscope and check for any small agglutinates. And I don't see any in this sample either. So another confirmed negative. And having confirmed the negative results on the D-control, then report those results on your result sheet. Now, to prove that this is a true negative, we need to add check cells, and that's the next step. So now we'll add one drop of the control cells, the check cells, to each of these tubes. And then we'll spin those down for 30 seconds in the centrifuge. Okay. And then read your check cell results. You need to have a 2 plus or greater reaction for your check cell results to be valid, to validate the test. And then just gently tap your tube, and you can see that it's chunking off, and it's a pretty nice strong reaction. That's at least a 2 plus. Now, it may be a few cells on the bottom that aren't check cells. You don't need to tap those off. And so this is a strong 2 plus. And then we'll read the control tube as well. And tap that reaction off. You can see the check cells lifting off. So now the check cells have been tapped off, and our reaction. It looks like another 2+. And we'll write that reaction on our report sheet and proceed to the interpretation of the Rh and the conclusion of our DU testing. So now let's look at our results from the DU testing. You can see that we got negative on the DU and negative on the DU control, and we got 2+ or greater for both of our check cell results. This confirms that we have an Rh negative patient. So in the interpretation for the foreword under type, we're going to write NEG, abbreviation for negative. This concludes the DU testing and the ABO-Rh testing procedure.